Good morning, explorers. How are we all today? I hope you enjoyed day one, which you just saw. And today, just a nice leisure day in Chester. I am going to have a walk down Shropshire Union Canal and just try and just enjoy my day. We're strolling past the castle now on the canal. I'm not sure where the canal leads, but it's a canal walk and we're doing today. I've just been to the Chester falconry experience, which I'm going to go back later at 2:30, where we might see some more flying things. But I've just held a golden eagle and a Gaia falcon, which was amazing. The golden eagle raided Tom Pickle.
right, so far, where was you this morning?
Liverpool.
Well, how'd you like Shrewsbury? Nice, isn't it? Yeah. Point, didn't it? Yes.
Yeah. A bit like this place, really, when you get into it, isn't it?
Have you got some free time? Yeah. You get rid of them too, do you? Yeah. On the brakes. Right. Yeah. And then you can enjoy the city better. It's there, but unfortunately we can't get at the other half of the amphitheatre because that building on the back of it is a listed building. In other words, we can't knock it down. Okay? That used to be their Catholic school. Can you see the cross on the top there? So we're in conflict now between the Romans and the Catholics on this one. Alright? Now the amphitheatre itself would have between 7,000 to 8,000 people. In the Marys, the Romans would put on displays that would be peace fighting. Midday it was used for army training, and in the afternoons it was executions. So did you see that first Wales? And the people of this city wouldn't give the Welsh the time of day. And if you don't believe me, you take a look at the town hall. It's got a four-sided tower, and again it's only got three clocks on it. They also passed a law, and the law stated this: if you find a Welshman inside these city walls after this, not much of it left now. What took its place was this big sandstone building, which used to be there planted with the Jesuit regiment. It's now all crowd burnt, and it's part of the university complex now. If you look to the right hand side, you can see the Rue D race course. Now the Rue D race course is the oldest continuous race course in this country. We've been racing horses here since 1539, continuously. The country that's at zero altitude. They all belong to the Duke, every single one. That gives you some idea of what he owns in the city. Now, if you look to your left hand side now, look at these cottages. Can you see them? How the window frames have been put in? That's because in the early days they used to have to pay what they call window tax, and it was based on this. If your property had six or more windows in it, you had to pay the tax. No ifs, no buts, you had to pay. Now a lot of people couldn't afford that, so what they...
Howdy Xplorers, how are you today? I've just did a half an hour tour on the Chester Vintage buzz behind me. Fascinating